In this video, we are going to create a sell stop for this parabolic SAR indicator. So let's find out how to do that with MQL5. To get started, please click on the little button here or press F4 on your keyboard. Now you should see the MetaEditor window, and here you want to click on File, New File, Expert Advisor from Template, Continue. I will call this file Simple SAR Sell Trailing Stop, click on Continue, Continue and Finish. Now you can delete everything above the onTick function and the two command lines here. We start with an include statement to include the file trade.mqh. Afterwards, we create an instance of the class ctrade that will be called trade. And we need it to open a test position so that we have something where we can place the trailing stop. As we are talking about a sell trailing stop, we need to calculate the bid price. That is done by using symbol info double. For the current symbol on the chart, we use symbol underscore bid, all in capital letters. And with normalized double and underscore digits, we make sure that we have the right number of digits behind the dot. Depending on the currency pair, that could be either 3 digits or 5 digits. And now we want to check if the number of current positions is below 1. So if we don't have any open positions, we use trade.sell to open a sell position for 10 micro lot. Please remember, we only do this on a demo account. We wouldn't do that on a real account. Now let's create an array. And once that is done, we use the integrated function ISAR for the current symbol on the chart and the currently selected period on that chart. And these two parameters here are what we see if you click on Insert, Indicators, Trend, Parabolic SAR. Here we have a step value of 0.02 and a max value of 0.2. So let's click on OK. Right click into the chart, select Templates, Save Template, and save it as tester.tpl because this is the template that we are going to use in the strategy test. So let's click on OK. We can replace the old value here and go back to the MetaEditor. So let's use array set as series to sort the array from the current candle downwards. And in the next step, we can use copy buffer to fill our SAR array according to the SAR definition that we have created here. We fill it for buffer 0, that's the first indicator line. In our case, that's the dotted line here. And we fill it from candle 0 for 3 candles and store the results in our SAR array. Because that makes it possible to calculate the current SAR value by looking into candle 0 in our SAR array. And with normalized double and comma 5, we make sure that the value will be calculated according to the definition of the parabolic SAR. You see here is the value 0.88997, that's 5 digits behind the dot, and that's also what we get when we do it this way. And the last part of the onTick function is to call a function called check SAR sell trailing stop. This one doesn't exist so far, so we need to code it now. And we will pass the bid price and the SAR value as parameters. So this is the function, it is called check SAR sell trailing stop. We take the two parameters here. The first one for the bid price is a double value, and that's also true for the second parameter, the SAR value. Now we use a for loop to go through all the open positions. First we use position get symbol for the current counter value to get the currency for the current position. Afterwards we want to check if the current symbol on the chart and the position symbol are equal. And if that is the case, we use position get integer and position underscore ticket, all in capital letters, to get the ticket number for the position. We use position get double, position underscore SL to get the current stop loss. And we only want to modify our stop loss if the current stop loss is above the current SAR value or if the current stop loss equals zero. That would be the case when we start up the expert advisor. And if you missed that part, you will never see any kind of trailing stop on your chart. If all of our conditions are true, we use trade.positionmodify for the current position ticket and set the stop loss to the SAR value. In this example, we will not modify the take profit value. Now, finally, we want to close all the loops, and that's about it. Well, if you don't understand what all the code here does, or if this was too fast for you, maybe you want to watch one of the other videos in this basic video series, or maybe even the premium course on our website might be interesting for you. For now, please click on the compile button here, or press F7 on your keyboard. I made a mistake. Usually that's a mistake about one of these curly braces. You see, when I mark this one, the second one that is highlighted is the one above. So let's add one here. This one closes the if statement here. This one belongs to the if statement above. This one is for the for loop. And this one is the end of the function. So let's recompile the code. And this time it worked. If this is also true in your case, please click on the little button here or press F4 to go back to MetaTrader. And in MetaTrader we have saved the template as tester.tpl before. If you haven't done that, please do that now. Because now we need to start the strategy tester. So we click on View, Strategy Tester or press Ctrl and R. Please pick the new file simple SAR sell trailing stop.ex5, mark the visual mode here, and start a test. Here we are, we have our first sell position, and as soon as the candles are on the other side of the indicator, we should see a sell trailing stop. Here we are. So our little expert advisor is working, and now you know how to code an SAR sell trailing stop in MQL5. And you have done it yourself with a few lines of code in the MetaEditor.